with Ben Harper on his Blind Boys project.
Yeah, There Will Be a Light is what it was called.
And it also won a Grammy, I believe, for Best Blues.
Yeah, it was like Best Soul, Gospel, Blues, something or other, funkiness.
Best album.
Yeah, well, I mean, when we did that record, it was me, Ben, Juan, and Jay, the keyboard player, the four of us sitting in a room together in the studio at Capitol, and he would just whip out a song, and we'd arrange it right there and cut it. So we cut five in one night, and then we cut five in another night, finished the record in 2 days.
Wow.
And so the four of us got statues, got Grammys, and it's an honor. I don't know where it is, but I know I got
it somewhere. Some of the book ended somewhere?
I don't know. I really haven't seen it in a long time.
Also, a lot of people might not know this. You are a NAACP award winner.
Yes, sir, I am. One of the few white boys that have one of them statues.
So what did they think about you getting that statue?
Well, Ben called me up and he goes, man, it was like pulling teeth getting you one of these damn things. I said, man, I've been playing you guys' music for 20 years. About time I get something.
So you're also producing, and you just produced Ryan Bingham.
Mm-hmm.
And
who is phenomenal, by the way. Just this kid is gonna, he's gonna be important, really, really, just as straight and honest as you get from anybody, and just great voice, great lyrics, and it's a great record. Comes out October 2nd on Lost Highway. The studio that I've been making these records at, the Compound in Signal Hill, Long Beach, California. What we decided we might try to do is put an online record store up, and we would have like an in-house band. And so instead of, you know, somebody coming along and making a demo for 6 days or a week or something, spending a fortune, they could spend a few days in there, have the house band whip up the tunes right then, they could sing over it, and they'd have a record out like next week online. You know, just only do it online and just crank out as much music as we can. I was thinking about putting like some of these extra, these songs, I've been writing so many songs, I've been jamming with these other guys of the projects, and maybe releasing like alternate takes of things, or, you know, I got a lot of like sessions that really have nowhere to go and no purpose. It's like I put those out, go to Compound Records and get this for free, you know, to try to draw some attention to it. So
nice.
I think it's a great idea. I mean, you know, these kids come in and they, you know, they blow mom and dad's money or something, or they save up and they end up with this, you know, they weren't ready to go in the studio, you know what I mean? And so they can just come in and get a rockin', but kind of a little Stax thing, you know, Motown.
Now, is this something that you're really, after, you know, after you go off tour, is this something you're really going to dive into? And
I'm into it. It's so rewarding for me because there's so many aspects to it. I had no idea, because you're in there concentrating nonstop for 16 hours a day, you know, or if you're a guitar player or something, you come in, you blow down some tracks, and then you just sit around bored all day, right? But like the hardest part is the sort of the personalities where, you know, you got egos, you gotta translate for the guitar player to talk to the drummer and make everybody's feelings all right. And, you know, I mean, it's an intense gig. I dig it. Plus, I get to play it.
So, and you played on Ryan Bingham's album as well?
Yeah, I did a lot of the bass, a lot of the guitars, and lap steels, and.
Now, is it true you first learned how to play lap steel when you, Black Crowes?
Yeah, I learned how to do a lot of things with them, because they would go, you know how to do something. Oh, yeah. don't worry about it. I just pick it up and figure it out real quick, you know.
On the first album, on Harmony.
Well, that was Slide.
That was Slide.
Slide guitar, yeah. But on another, I forget which one it was.
Well, you first learned to play Slide on that album?
Well, yeah, because, you know, when I was joining the band, I was asked if I could play it, and I said, oh, yeah. And so, you know, I'm going, oh, shit, what am I going to do? What finger does it go on? And I saw a picture of Ronnie Wood with it on his middle finger. I go, well, that goes on your middle finger.
Yeah.
So, you know, and So that's why I played in standard tuning mostly, because I didn't know where the notes were in open tuning. So it actually turns out it's harder in standard tuning. But
so how long did it take you to actually get comfortable with them?
I'm still not comfortable with it.
No.
It's a beautiful sound, and it's it's a whole different trip. You really got to spend a lot of time on it, and I don't. So I'm kind of a hack slide player.
Oh, well, I'm sure a lot of people would disagree with that.
Well, they'll get a kick.
Yeah. Yeah, real quick, you want, don't mess with this guy when he's playing, because when he was in Moscow, you want to take it from here?
there was a drunken man who insisted that he should be playing harmonica on one of our songs, uninvited, and he was cross-eyed smash. I looked at him and I was like, no, you know, nuh-uh. And then he'd come up and get close and go away, and he'd go back and come up again. And so I put my foot in his chest and sent him into the PA column. And he got up and tried to do it again, and, you know, Mighty grabbed him by the throat and walked him off without missing a beat, you know. Me and Mighty kept playing. Elijah and Dennis were so freaked out by the whole, they stopped, and I turned around, I go, keep playing! Bam, we went right back, and it was cool.
Then he came back the next night.
Yeah, but I didn't remember this, but yeah, he came around and then apologized, which is, you know, even sweeter on the whole deal. I got to kick somebody in the chest off the stage and get a name for it, which is fantastic.
Kung Fu.
Marc Kung Fu Ford. And then he apologized, so it's a win-win situation, really.
Nice. Well, I think our trip is ending, so... I'd like to thank you very much for coming up here with us in this gondola up here on this beautiful day up here in Telluride, Colorado. And it's been a pleasure, Marc.
Yes, it has.
And we'll have some fun tonight.
Okay, cool.
See ya.
Bye. All about music, that's what you get.